Good morning, students. I, Vidyasagar, welcome you all in the e-learning class of Modern International School, Hiswa. I am going to start subject history of standard 8, and this is my second video lecture on this topic, chapter 3, ruling the countryside. Now, I want to told you all that in the previous topic we have discussed that how the British Lord Clive, who has received the Diwani of the Bengal, and how he has introduced the permanent settlement, which was introduced by Lord Cornwallis, and how it was in a fixed pattern through which the peasants, they were getting the lot of problems. Now we will also discuss about the problem which was evolved by the permanent settlement. Now the problems that was creating here, that those jamindars who were responsible for collecting the tax, and finally they have to give it to the British, but and they have to also invest for the development of the land. But what was seen here, that lot of problem was emerging there, that the jamindars, they were not properly investing toward the land, and due to the high taxation, the peasants, they were also not giving the properly the taxes, and as the tax was the important source for the British, so they became very facing the problems. And by the 19th centuries, the situation changed as the market expanded, but the cultivation was slowly expanded. It means what? There was no any promotion for the cultivation, wherever the for the receiving of taxation, it was too many programs was made out there. That's why the cultivation grew very slowly, and those jamindars who ever don't used to collect the proper taxes, their land also going to be seized by the British, and they could also used to lost their lands. As jamindars, they were also not taking the interest to improve the lands, and as they have also used to lost their lands, jamindari also, because at that time it was there that those jamindars who will not pay the taxes regularly, their land will be captured by the British, and that's why the moral identity of the jamindars was also depriving. And other were also telling that jamindar could give out the land of tenant to get rent, and they were not interested in improving the land. As well as the jamindars, they were thinking about it that British, they are making their own profits, and they are not giving us the share, the proper share to us. That's why they were not taking the interest in the land. Wherever on the other hand, the cultivators, they were very extreme opposite toward the British and their systems. And the rent which they used to pay, which was very high, and the jamindars, they were and they were also the peasants, they were also were insecure about their lands, and they have to take for the paying of taxation, they have to take money from the money lenders, and whenever they used to not pay the money lenders on the right time, their land also used to be loose. So here was a critical situation which was evolving day by day. As they were thinking, the British, they were thinking about it, because land was the only source from which they were getting the taxation. As a new system which was devised. Now, by the early 19th century, the company officials convinced the system of revenue has to be changed again, because as they were thinking that whatever the permanent system was applied, but the peasants, they were not able to pay it as the taxation was very high. So they were thinking about it and they were just telling that it should be changed. It means the taxation, the system of collecting the tax should be changed. So in the eastern part, like in the north western part, which is the province of Bengal Presidency, and most of the part which is now in Uttar Pradesh, an Englishman called Holt McKenzie, which was introduced a new system, came effect in 1822, as he has taken and he has ordered his collectors to measure the lands, to measure that how we can get the profits, and by measuring the lands they should make into a groups that was known as Mahal, and the all the revenue that should be collected, and there the responsibility of collecting the tax should be on the village headman, as rather than it was not for the jamindars. So the group of the village which was considered as Mahal, that's why this system was known as Mahal Wari system. Dear students, three types of taxation was there: permanent settlement, Mahalwari system, and Rayatwari system, as I have told you earlier. Now, so group of the village which were paying their taxes to the headman, these were considered as Mahalwari system. Next is the Munro system. The Munro, who was the governor of Madras during 1819 to 1826, as the third, which was the Rayatwari system. Rayat, it means directly the peasant. So in the southern part of the India, after the battle of the Anglo-Mysore battle, after the defeat of the Tipu Sultan, captain who was Alexander Reed, and with the help of the Thomas Munro, they have evolved a new system which was known as Rayatwari. As they told that the taxation which should be neither taken by the headman, it should be just given by the Rayats, it means directly by the peasants, and those peasants, they will be directly responsible for giving the taxes. So this system was known as Rayat Wari because these were given by the directly, these taxes were directly paid by the peasants. That's why it was known as the Rayat Wari system. As the different survey which have also been done by the Munro and Alexander Reed, that it was done that different survey that how much taxation they could get from it. As they were also telling that the British, they should just act like their fathers, as for protecting the rights under their charge. All next topic is all was not well, as within the few years the new system which was imposed in different part of the countries, the for a burning desire to get the lot of taxation, to collect the lot of revenue, but it was not happening. So as the peasants, they were unable to pay, riots flashed to the countryside because still they were feeling that the taxation was very high, and the village became the deserted in many reasons. It means somehow it was the system which was good, the Rayatwari as well as the Mahalwari, it was something flexible. Some flexibility has been opted, but in the mid of that, some of the bureaucrats who used to just suck out the peasants too much, and that's why the peasants were unable to pay the high taxation, and just they were leaving their traditional occupations. And that's why some of the optimistic officials, they were also imagines the new system that would emerge, that would transform the peasants into a rich entrepreneur farmers. But this was not happened, because all the peasants, they were not able to pay the taxation, as there were different problem was also which was facing by them. Okay, dear friends, read the paragraph and watch the video carefully. Thank you.